It's a beautiful little girl. Oh, here's your daughter, Count Vronsky. Unfortunately, Excellency, it was too much for your wife.
What?
Let's cover her up.
No, Corinne. I'm alive.
No. You're right, madam.
Yes. Where's my husband?
At the council. He'll be back after dinner.
Anushka. To the Count. Hurry.
Mama, I heard you scream.
Oh, I just had a bad dream.
Mothers have them too.
Oh? Uh-huh.
The news that Anna was expecting Vronsky's child had reached me. Engrossed in the work in the fields and my plans for reform, I felt safe. Safe from the tumultuous passion of city life. But when I saw her, that delusion vanished. I loved Kitty more than life itself.
Tell me that your husband wasn't at home.
He forgot a folder. How could I have known that?
It's fine, don't worry. It doesn't matter. Tell me about yourself. How are you feeling?
What took you so long?
I was part of the Prince of Sweden's escort. He wanted to go to the opera.
Was that friend of yours there? That... Thrays.
Yes, she was there. She's an actress. But why should it matter?
You men can be disgusting.
That's a little unfair, isn't it?
What do I know of what you do?
Anna. You don't believe in me anymore?
When you're with me, I do. When you're with others, I don't know.
That's because of the absurd compromise your husband has imposed on us. I'd rather he had challenged me to a duel.
A duel? A duel requires feelings. My husband's a machine.
I'd be dead or he would, but the situation would be resolved.
And it will be soon resolved anyway.
Yes. You'll be having the baby and then what? We'll carry on like this, seeing each other in secret, like thieves.
Best thing that could happen. You'll all be free. You, my husband, my son, our child.
Free? That's absurd.
I felt the baby.
Where? Kick's eye.
We had an agreement, you and I. You promised not to cause a scandal. And now
You receive your lover here? In my own home?
It was an accident. I just needed to...
Oh, I can easily imagine why a woman needs to see her lover.
Why must you insult me?
It's not an insult to call a thief a thief.
You're cruel.
Cruel? I gave you a choice. You could go with him or stay in my home. In return, I didn't ask you to leave him, only to respect convention. You decided to stay. And now you call me cruel.
Convention, reputation, that's all you care about.
You'd also care about it if you weren't such a slut. You promised to love me, to be faithful, before men and before God. And now you betray me, here. In our home.
No one knows better than I, how contemptible my situation is.
A situation that will be soon ending. I am leaving for Moscow. You'll be hearing from my lawyer. I'll divorce you. This will no longer be your home.
And my son?
He will stay with his father.
No, please let me have Seryozha. You don't love him.
You're right. Reminds me of you. But he has to be with me.
Your letters tell the truth. You look good. I thought I'd be curing the sick in Germany, but instead they cured me. Don't you think about Vronsky anymore?
I do. But it doesn't hurt now.
That's good.
Good.
Because Mother must be dying to introduce you to someone else.
I'm not interested in that game anymore.
Levin was here today.
I talked to him about you.
Was I wrong to?
What did he say?
That doesn't matter, but I'm convinced that he still loves you. What about you? What do you feel for him?
I don't know. I no longer trust what I feel.
That's a good thing. If I were to trust my feelings, I'd marry again my husband on even days, and then abandon him on odd ones. Hey, get down! Down! Down. You just need to see each other again, and then whatever happens, happens.
I can't expect him to propose to me again.
You sound just like him. You're made for each other. Let me handle it.
I'll send him a note right away. I'll write to say that we need a lady's saddle and that I would like him to bring us one personally.
Say there's no reply.
It's only a saddle. You could take it to her, sir.
That's what you get when you teach your servants to read. They no longer know their place.
I'm just saying what your mother would say.
I can't expect Kitty to turn to me just because she couldn't marry the man she wanted.
Why don't you let her be the judge of that? We women can be wrong too, can't we?
Be as wrong as you want. I'm not playing the role of the man who forgives her. The man who deigns to give her his love.
Well, all I say is this. You should do less thinking and get yourself married.
Agafia! Pack my bags, I'm leaving.
Where to?
France, then England. Agricultural work there is organized differently. I have to find out about it for my book.
Ah, your book? Yes.
It's important. It'll change the lives of all the peasants in Russia.
It will change theirs, maybe. But yours will still be the same.
Hey, is your saddle, madam?
No message from Levin?
No message.
Thank you. I'm sorry. Hey. Let's go back to the city.
Another push? 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 That's right.
Don't worry. Everything will be all right. She'll be fine. It's the same when you were born, you know.
You can't know. You weren't there.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Call the doctor.
Anushka. Anushka. Send a telegram to Karenina Moscow. Right. I'm dying. I pray that you come. I beg you come. I shall die more peacefully with your forgiveness. Go!
Now, there are two possible ways of going about a divorce. The first is based on an agreement concerning the respective faults.
Respective? But I'm not the one at fault.
That leaves us the second option, then. One of the spouses is recognized as being the sole guilty party.
These were written by my wife. They're proof that she's been unfaithful to me.
You know that the spouse recognizes the guilty party is not eligible to marry again.
Meaning that my wife won't be able to marry her lover after the divorce.
Exactly.
That's what I want.
It's a girl, madam.
See the baby. She's dying. She's lost a lot of blood. She won't survive.
What do you want to call her? Anna. Today one dies, and one is born.
Mom?
Karenina.